My poster is about a new application of a data assimilation method to compute time series of deformation from interferogram with INSAR. We focus on volcanic and tectonic application of this method. This poster is divided in four parts. First, I present the theory of our Kalman filter time series analysis, or KFTS in short, with how the algorithm proceeds. Second, I show how we made up synthetic INSAR data and used them to validate the method. Then, on the right, further validation is provided by real case application of KFTS and the comparison of the output with trusted measures, like GPS time series over Mount Etna in Sicily, or INSAR time series computed using NSBAS, the new small baseline method, over the Chaman fault zone in Afghanistan and Pakistan. Those test cases are also a way to display the new possibilities offered by this method, including error propagation through the network of interferograms and complex parameterization to model local processes. Now, in more detail, the problem we are trying to address is how can we efficiently deal with the large flux of incoming SAR images? A question that will become more and more relevant with the launch of the numerous SAR missions planned. So a Kalman filter is a data assimilation algorithm which iteratively combines past estimate with new incoming data as it becomes available in two processing steps, the forecast and the analysis. We apply the method to reconstruct the evolution of the interferometric phase at each time step, together with the parameter of a time-dependent model and associated uncertainties for each pixel independently. It means that we solve for those two equations. So at the top, you have the definition of an interferogram, where you have with some error that comes from mainly processing. And at the bottom, you have a functional description of deformation that corresponds to this red line. And we adjust for the coefficient AN, which are a multiplicating coefficients of the linear combination of functions. So any function fn, that is a function of time. And you also have an error in this modeling of the phase change that is called mismodeling and accounts temporally uncorrelated noise of the time series, so mainly coming from atmospheric delays. So the model is used to make a forecast at a future time step. The forecast is then refined by including unwrapped interferograms. So we obtain a new estimate of the phase and its standard deviation, and we update the past phase estimates, including the phases that were incorporated in the interferograms. And we also update our knowledge about the functional description of deformation. So, to conclude, KFTS allows for the rapid update of pre-existing models with newly acquired data. Thus, it has the potential to absorb the huge flux of incoming INSAR data while refining knowledge of deformation over time. So in order to properly combine the forecast with new data, correct measure of the relative uncertainties is key. Tunable parameters include predefined errors, like the standard deviation of the misclosure, standard deviation of the mismodeling error, and the a priori uncertainties on model parameters AN, which are used for the initialization step. So it allows us to do to make a first forecast when we have no data. So we applied extensive tests to better define optimal parameterization. In synthetic tests, so where we know our target, the final output of KFTS is exactly the weighted least squares solution. So what you see is that you see the convergence of the parameters toward the dashed line, which is the least square solution. The true value is a dotted line. So this is the evolution of the parameter for one pixel of the study area. So a first real case example is the application of KFTS on a set of ANVISAT interferograms already used in several validation studies, including Duan et al. 2011. So you have the cumulative phase change with its standard deviation. It's 0.01 on the volcano flank and more than 10 millimeters outside in the agricultural area, because not many interferograms are unwrapped in those regions. Differential time series of displacement in the satellite line of sight from GPS and INSAR. So there is good correlation between the KFTS output and the GPS time series. Let us now look at the example of the Chaman fault zone in Afghanistan and Pakistan. So on the left, you have a map of the ground velocities with its associated histogram of uncertainty. So the Y scale is logarithmic, which means that the wide majority of pixels have uncertainties smaller than 0.5 millimeters per year. So that's the uncertainty on the velocities. So on the right, you have the full expression of the functional description of deformation. We use velocity A1, a seasonal term, and amplitude of step function centered on earthquake timing used to quantify co-seismic displacement. So you have an example there for a magnitude 5.6, where the co-seismic displacement is limited spatially by, so the model co-seismic step, by the shape of the a priori. So this poster is just a brief overview. If you want more details on the equation, the parameterization, and see more extensive testings, please refer to the published paper with the reference over there. And don't hesitate to contact me and download the code. Thank you.